Let us now calculate the gradient of this line. In another video, we had calculated the gradient of a line that went this way. Now let's calculate the gradient of the line, this particular line, and see what it is. Now, can you tell what the sign, whether positive or negative, this gradient will be? Let's see. Remember now, to find the gradient, we choose two points. Let's say this point and let's say this point. All right? Two points on the line. We can draw from one point a vertical line and draw from the other point a horizontal line. Then we calculate the rise over the run by saying the height of the triangle is the rise and the width of the triangle is the run. Remember, vertical line, the horizontal line, and part of this line form the entire triangle. Alright? Now, here, the rise in this case will be from here up, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up. So our rise is 6, and we want to divide by our run. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4 across, which is the 6 divided by 4. Now here we would have 1.5, but what about the sign, whether it's positive or negative? Let's see something here. I had said in another video that if you're going from left to right, you want to go from left to right, and you're climbing the line, which is the side of a hill, and you're going down, it is a negative. So let's see how we determine whether it's a positive or a negative from the points. You have this as point 1 and this as point 2. You're moving from point 1 to point 2. Here, you are going this way downwards. As you move from point 1 to point 2, vertically you're moving down from here to here, horizontally you're moving to the right. Downwards means a negative direction. So this 6 is a negative 6. So negative 6 divided by going to the right is in a positive direction. So you're moving in the direction of positive 4. A negative divided by a positive gives you a negative. Negative 6 divided by a positive 4 is a negative 5. So that tells you the sign would be negative. Another thing you can do here is this. Let's say we move from point 2 up to point 1. From point 2 to point 1. Going from point 2 to point 1, if you consider going vertically from point 2 to point 1, you would be going up 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 points, 6 units. Going from point 2 to point 1, you'll be going up. So this 6 would now be positive. But guess what? As you go from point 2 to point 1, this direction, 4 units, you'd be going to the left. So the 4 would be a negative. So you'd have positive 6 over negative 4, which is a negative 1.5. So you still cannot escape it. It's a negative gradient that you will have, right? Because remember, along the x, left to right means you're increasing and you're going in the positive direction. Right to left means you're decreasing in value and you're going to in the negative direction. And along the y-axis, up is in the positive direction, you're increasing in y. Down is in the negative direction, you're decreasing in values of y. Now, let us also look at dealing with this. using our coordinates. We use this point as our point one. So this point will give our x1 and our y1, right? And this point down here, at this point we have our x2. Let's not draw it here. This point will be our x2 and our y2. Now, what exactly is the point that we're dealing with here? Right? What exactly is the point that we're dealing with here on this graph? This, the value of x is 6 because this point is directly, is negative 6. This point is directly above negative 6. So our x1 is negative 6, comma, our y1, where is it beside? It is beside 9. So our y1 is 9. Good. What about this one? This point is directly above negative 2. You can see it here. So our x2 is negative 2. And our y2, it lines up vertically beside, horizontally beside 3. So y2 is 3. Let's do a calculation now. Let's say we try y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Y2 is 3 minus y1 is 9 divided by x2, which is negative 2 minus x1. X1 is what? Negative 6. So we have 3 minus 9. 3 minus 9 is negative 6 divided by negative 2 minus negative 6 is what? It's same as negative 2 plus 6. So this gives us negative 6 over negative 2 plus 6 is a positive 4. So negative 6 over positive 4 will be negative 1.5. Alright? Now imagine that instead of y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, what we have is y1 minus y2 over x1 minus x2. What would happen? Y1 is 9 minus y2 is 3 divided by x1 is negative 6 minus x2 is negative 2. So 9 minus 3 is positive 6 divided by negative 6 minus negative 2 is going to be negative 6 plus 2. So this is 6 over negative 6 plus 2 is negative 4. Positive 6 over negative 4 gives you a negative 1.5. So it's a negative 1.5. Now, one more thing. What would happen if we mixed up the order of the ones and twos? So if we put y1 minus y2 over x2 minus x1. So we start with one up top and start with two down the bottom. What would happen? Let's see. Y1 is 9 minus y2. What is y2? Down here is 3 divided by x2 is negative 2 minus x1, which is negative 6. So this would be 9 minus 3, which is 6, over negative 2 minus negative 6, which is the same as negative 2 plus 6. What you would have is 6 divided by 4, and that would give you a positive 1.5. So the sign would be wrong if you mix up the order in which you put the y's and x's. You would get the same number for the gradient but the wrong sign. So therefore, you should be consistent with your numbering for the y's and x. You must not mix them up. What you must do is either use the formula y1 minus y2 over x1 minus x2, or y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, but don't try to switch them around. All right, be consistent with the ordering of the x and y's. So that's our gradient for this line. It is negative 1.5, but don't switch around or mix up the order of the x's and the y's. Keep them consistently in the same formula.